Donald Trump, in an interview that aired this past weekend on Brian Kilmeade's Fox News show, not Fox and Friends, his other show, was asked about the debate by Kilmeade. And Donald Trump, who of course is still stewing about the debate, said that it was probably the best debate he's ever had. And of course that ABC should be investigated for all the fake claims that Republicans have been making about them ever since the debate happened. Now keep in mind, by the time they did this interview, it was almost 2 weeks past the debate. And Trump is so hung up on his horrible performance during that debate that he's still bitching about it. So here is how that went down. Trump said, quote, "I thought it was a great debate for me. I thought it was one of my best debates that I've ever had. And some people disagree, but I thought it was the strongest debate I ever had." 67% of Americans said you lost. So, you know, just throwing that out there. Some people disagree. No, most people disagree. But then Trump said, "I thought I was treated very unfairly by ABC. It was 3-on-1, but that was okay too. I thought we did really well. We exposed it." And then he was asked, "Well, has ABC apologized?" And Trump said, "Has ABC apologized yet? No, it's a very unfair process." So then Kilmeade pointed out that a former Hillary Clinton advisor, Mark Penn, who has since moved to the right since her failed presidential run, Mark Penn pointed out that, hey, ABC News rigged the outcome, as if that makes any sense. And then Kilmeade said, "Do you join in those questions, asking if ABC rigged the outcome?" And Trump said, "Sure I do. I think they should be investigated. And you know, they have to get a license from the federal government." So it's a threat. It's not just you saying, "Hey, we're just asking questions here." No, you're already threatening them. You're like, "If I get back in office, they have to get a license from me because I will be the federal government." That's what he's implying there. I hope everybody understands that and was able to read between the lines and get it. But that's what he's saying. There is no evidence, aside from this anonymous whistleblower, which, by the way, that story kind of went away real quick, didn't it? Huh, wonder what happened to that. But anyway, that one alleged whistleblower who says, "I totally heard them talking about this," and that's it. Like, there's nothing more to the story. That's literally it. Somebody claims they heard other people talking, which, by the way, is actually how the Haitian migrant story evolved too. Somebody making up a claim because I heard somebody say something to somebody else and then I'm just running with it. And this is what you get. ABC News has nothing to gain from rigging a debate in Kamala Harris's favor. If anything, the network is better off if Donald Trump wins the election, which I talked about last week. But this is what it is. Trump lost. He knows he lost. And that's why, one, he's refusing to do another debate with her. And two, why now we're more than 2 weeks past it and that lunatic can't stop crying about it. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.